It was great to be a knight in shining armor, but it felt like I was rattling around in an old tin can. Now this is much more comfortable. You know, hundreds of years ago, if you wanted a new shirt, you had to spin it by hand. And you spun it on a spinning wheel like this. The fiber goes into the wheel there and comes out as yarn. Now here's a famous fairy tale about a young girl whose spinning wheel didn't spin fiber into yarn, but straw into gold. It's called Rumpelstiltskin.
They cast the spell. The rest of us have only to sit back and share the magic.
I thought I put everything together. What did the animators most enjoy doing? They most enjoyed working in the manner in which we worked on Song of the South. Where could I get animal creatures that were somewhat like Song of the South, and what kind of a picture? Sort of a charade, a burlesque of some well-known fantasy story or some picture of what would be a Robin Hood. Aha. And what is it that an animal would be best suited for but a fox, a wily fox, a little fellow who's being preyed on by the Sheriff of Nottingham and then I thought King Richard Lionhearted, is the lion and his sneaky little half-brother, Prince John, who's an undernourished lion, Sir Hiss, the snake, and the Sheriff of Nottingham is a wolf, and all these things, and it was a good fun picture to work on.
The studio next took aim on the legend of Robin Hood, and Larry realized that with such a colorful cast of supporting characters, the hero had to be straight as an arrow.
He had to be more of a straight star. He had to be the Mickey Mouse. The story evolved around him. To believe him to be the hero of the story, you couldn't take too many liberties with him. You could have your fun with your other characters.
Taxes! Taxes! Beautiful, lovely taxes! Aha! Aha!
Sire, you have an absolute skill for encouraging contributions from the poor.
Once there was a poor miller who had a beautiful daughter. On his way to town one day, the miller encountered the king. Wanting to impress him, the miller said,
I have a daughter who knows the art of spinning straw into gold.
Now the king had a passion for gold, so he ordered the miller to send his daughter to the castle straight away.
To coin a phrase, my dear counselor, rob the poor to feed the rich. Am I right?
The key to these characters is making them think and making the expressions on their face that register what they're thinking, what their feelings are, what's going on in the mind. And I think that's the key to Disney animation, and what Walt always asked for.
As one animator said, thinking back on those days, he said, it looked like every last frame of film was manicured. Someone had just worked over to pack every last thing you could into it, and they had.
I do as much research as possible, not in books, but in newspapers of the period, because even if newspapers don't always express the truth about something, they certainly express the prejudices, and dramatically that's very useful.
And how well King Richard's crown sits on your noble brow.
Doesn't it?
King Richard! I've told you never to mention my brother's name.
If somebody tells you that you've got Parkinson's disease, it starts a new thing altogether. You expect anything to happen. I mean, the best part of me now are my earlobes, and they're still firm and muscular.
One more hiss out of you. Hiss. And you are walking to Nottingham.
Snakes don't walk, they slither.
Rumpelstiltskin sure had a knack for getting the most out of a spinning wheel. And so do the spinners here at the fair. They don't turn straw into gold, but they do turn raw sheep's wool into beautiful threads of red, green, and gold.
We knew that this was something that they hadn't done before.
So what we're doing with John is something we've never had the license to do before.
Here's a chance to put our money where our mouth is and say, okay, you've been complaining about this feature and that feature, and if I were to do an animated feature, here you go, and let's do it.
Typically, a Disney film is fairy tales, retelling a fairy tale.
Rasputin is such a colorful...
This crown gives me a feeling of power! Power!
He's dead, but he's still not dead. He lives somewhere in limbo.
Hey!
Hmm? Hey, what? What do you say?
Ah, forget it. Your mind's not on food. You're thinking about somebody with long eyelashes. And you're smelling that sweet perfume.
I don't think it's possible to be a top-notch animator without being a very excellent draftsman. You have to be able to draw these characters in order to move them around and articulate them. You know? So there's no way of doing it unless you draw very well.
I found in the cat, in the kitten, something that was warm. And the job, of course, was to make him come alive as a personality. So what do? You say, well, how old is he? All right, he's a spunky 4-year-old kid or 3-year-old kid, whatever you want. How will they react in a given condition in certain situations?
When we'd be reading Andersen's fairy tales, he'd be reading the Hans with History of the World. And he would always talk about, what a wonderful warlord out there, and see the world and all this kind of thing, see? Well, the only way we could see the world was if somebody extra expense joined the army.
Well, what have we got here?
Now, just a minute, Sheriff. That's the poor box.
It sure is, and I'll just take it for poor Prince John.
And we would rough out our animation over that and shoot pencil tests on it to get the director's approval. And once those got approved, it would go through the normal steps of in-between and cleanup. And then those would get sent into ink and paint, and it was a little different because we had to layer effects elements over all of the animation.
Tell me, sir, is it a game of skill or a game of luck?
For some skill, for some luck. For me, skill, for you, bad luck.
My skill is not a question, 'tis your luck that has me worried.
When you look at that face on the screen and the whole face works together, when you smile, the eyes smile, the mouth smiles, your ears even move. This is something, when we do it right, the whole thing lights up and it's like a magic lantern. You see this face. And it's living.
Artist always goes back to the source. If he's drawing animals, he looks at the giraffes and the lions, and he caricatures them. But he starts out drawing realistically, like on Bambi, the guys used to go down at the zoo and see how the animals acted.
And it just strikes. I said, this is a movie that I'd like to go out and see, but this is a movie that we're not going to exactly see overnight. This is going to take years to make.
The first take was always a walkthrough carrying these large rubber dummies of Roger Rabbit and the weasels. And that would place the camera move and set up the pacing and staging of the shot.
Gee, Robin Hood really give it to you?
Yeah, this is his own hat, too.
Gee, I'd sure like to shoot your bow now.
Let me try it, Skippy.
Oh, no, you don't. I'm going to shoot it first.
So when Bob Hoskins was there, or Joanna Cassidy, they needed something to focus on, some reference point, because they're just looking to thin air. And they had the puppet there. They had the dummy right there on the set.
Does this help?
Uh-oh, now you've done it.
Ryan, Prince John's backyard.
I've seen other shows that have live action animation combination, and the people aren't looking at them at all. And you can tell, even if they're looking at them, it looks like they're looking through them, not looking at them. It looks like they're looking into dead space, only at the same island.
Well, there's nothing like a good dunking to cool you off on a hot day, and nothing like a good book to warm you up again. So if you like Rumpelstiltskin, then here are some other hearty tales that will whet your appetite. But you don't have to take my word for it.
early in the shoot, we broke for lunch and we all went to the commissary at the studio. And Charlie went in wearing his rabbit outfit. And we overheard a couple of the guys in the commissary going, "Geez, did you get a load of that Roger Rabbit movie? That's gonna be awful. Did you see the rabbit?"
Skippy, you can't go in there.
Yeah, Prince John will chop off your head.
Like this.
Who's that woman now doing that nasty show? What's her name? Anne Robinson talking about...
Yeah.
You know, that nasal voice she's got, talking about Montana.
As far as my scientific career goes, of course there was the decision that I made in 1945, 46 perhaps, but starting in 1945, and that may have been made by my wife rather than me, to sacrifice part of my scientific career to working for control of nuclear weapons and for the achievement of world peace.
Cinderella was being handled as a real girl. The stepsisters is cartoon real girls. The mice were cartoons, the cat was cartoon, the horse, the dog, all of them were cartoon characters. But the thing that made the picture work was the stepmother. She was the force through the whole thing. She had to be believable. She had to look real to the audience, even though she was far from real. And she had to match in drawing Cinderella and the stepsisters.
Well, the Queen has thanked me for attending. And I thank you for joining me. What a celebration! It's been so much fun that now I know why they call it the Pleasure Fair. But even Rumpelstiltskin couldn't have spun a more pleasurable day. So, good morrow and fare thee well. I'll see thee next time.
To pieces and he robs us of our bread. King Richard's crown keeps slipping down around that pointed head. Ah, but while there is a merry man in Robin's wily pack, we'll find a way to make him pay and steal our money back. The snivering, groveling, measly, weasley, blabbering, jabbering, gibbering, jabbering, fluttering, plotting, wheeling, dealing. John, that phony king of England. Yeah.